For X, it was a bit of a problem because there was nothing like 100. In fact, there were only 37. And of those 37, almost a third were XTC. So XTC it is.
I could name XTC, X-Mal Deutschland, X-Ray Specs, X Californian Band. Oh, yeah, and a couple of other punky ones. Let me see. Yeah, 72, I got together with Colin Moulding and Terry Chambers. Colin Moulding on bass, Terry on drums. And we called ourselves the Helium Kids, which I thought was a fast, modern name. But the music was anything but fast and modern. It was very turgid. We weren't getting anywhere at all. And around about 75, in fact, it was 75, I thought, nope, we need a complete change of image, a complete music overhaul. This is not how I hear it going. We changed our name to XTC, which I thought was much more modern.
You may know some people who are a little behind in the times. This is about a girl who is just like that. It's called She Says Square. Take it away, Johnny.
We're going to sing about modern things. We're going to sing about radios and televisions and electric communication, it's all going to be very modern. We did a demo session at CBS Studios in London and had some cassettes made up of this, and somebody said, well, we should send these to John Peel. So, you know, posted off a cassette, didn't think anything more about it. But he turned up to a gig we were doing in London. In fact, I don't think I knew he was in the audience till the end of the gig. And somebody said, oh, you know, that's John Peel came to see you. And I thought, well, I wonder if he liked the tape, you know, that we sent him. I think it was more the poster, actually, that we sent him that he liked. But a little while after that, he got in touch with our management and said, would the chaps like to come and do a session for me? You know, record a session. Wow, we don't even have a record deal. You know, we don't have a record label or anything. We barely have the petrol money. And so we went to Maida Vale and did a session. It was incredibly exciting because we hadn't been in a pro studio before then. Take change of underpants, you know. You have a Peel session and the great man has put his stamp of approval on you, and then record companies were literally fighting each other to sign us. When Go 2 came out, we gave away an EP of dubs of some of the tracks. And I remember he played this EP or a track or two one evening, except it didn't sound right to me. He was playing it at the wrong speed. He played it on 33, thinking it was an album, and loved it, you know. And I'm sat there thinking, oh, my God, has nobody twigged? This is, you know, this is now going to run for about 7 minutes instead of 3.5 minutes, and it's really low because it's at the wrong speed. I don't know whether he noticed or not. He seemed to love it. He probably preferred it than, you know, the correct speed. We did a session in 79, I think it was, where this bright spark here had the idea to, well, why don't we actually play the Peel music? And I'll do an impression of John Peel and rattle off a load of silly bands that are supposedly on the show that night. Not only did he like it, he actually opened the show with it.
Hello, my name is John Peel. On tonight's programme, I'll be playing tracks by The Sloot, The Slot, The Groan, Exploding Truss, The Blues Bastards, One from the Geckos, Hubert and His Pile Tones, The Ear, The Nose, The Throat, The Cassowaries from Hell are here, and Inevitable Groin. So, on to tonight's first guest, and they're XTC, who are by the way, here to answer all allegations that the 1979's answer to the Baron Knights. We'll see what you think.
John Peel hadn't said, "You're having my stamp of approval by being on my show," I doubt whether we would have had a record deal. Fantastic. An enormous debt of gratitude is owed from XTC to John Peel.